In this session, we look at type any and type while. Let's start with type any. So in some situations, not all type informations are available. Or to find that declaration will take an unnecessary amount of effort. So these may occur for values from code that has been written without using TypeScript or using any third-party libraries. So in these cases, we might want to opt out the type checking so that our compiler will allow us to continue with our further compilation. So to do this, we label these values with the type any. Alright, let's go ahead and see how it works in real time. So now I declare a variable called, sorry, a function called getValue, which can accept the parameter type string. And if you notice, we didn't have any, I mean, return type declared inside that function. Anyhow, we declare a function, but it's not proper way of. And now we are not going to create a proper function with a proper return type. So let's try access this. So if you noticed, even though we declared the return type as any to this particular function which we declared, but if we try to access that function, still it's an undefined function. So the compiler allows to execute and continue our code into the runtime, but anyhow it is blocking in the runtime. So that means compiler allows us without having proper return values to that function. So this is a wrong case, right? And yeah, even though this is causing issue in runtime. So that's how the type any will help us to opt out the compilation check. So yeah, let me try show one more thing. And unlike the type unknown, variables of type any allow us to access arbitrary properties. Even though we do not have that particular type which is accessible to particular arbitrary properties. So let me write some code so that we can understand it deeply. So I declared a variable with type any and assigned a number value to it, and trying to call one function. If you notice, we do not have any function called if it exists of in our class level. So yeah, but still the compilation pauses, and if you notice here, we got a runtime error saying that loosely typed that if it exists is not a function. So we do not have any defined function. So it is blocking us in the runtime. Even if you try access any arbitrary function later to any type, still it allow you to do that as well. So now, in runtime, if you notice, we we didn't face, I mean, any issue saying that do fixed of is not in function, because it is an arbitrary function, I mean property to the type number, and anyhow this is exist. And what if I try to command this line? Then if you noticed, so we are no longer facing the runtime error, because this is to fixed is an valid property, I mean property or function to this type number. And let's try to do same with type unknown, so that we can differentiate and understand the difference with the type any and type unknown. Now, if you noticed, still we are not getting anything, I mean, any issue in runtime, but still we are getting a compilation warning saying that property to fixed does not exist on type unknown. Yeah, because we declared this type as unknown, and we are trying to use an arbitrary property of the type number. So that's why it's complaining us. And if you remember in earlier video, we tried creating an type check. Strictly typed, not equal to number. If you do that and see, in this case, you are not getting any runtime warning saying that this particular property cannot be accessible with this created variable. So yeah, if you understand the difference, I mean the difference between the type any and unknown type unknown, still with the type unknown we have type checking, and if you go with any, so we are actually opt out of type checking, so which is basically cost of losing the type safety. And in this case also, if you try compare this type with the different type, and inside that if you try to access the same thing, and this time it will show you this two fix does not exist on type string. So because we are writing a condition saying that, I mean, compare whether it is equivalent with type string or not, but internally we are using yeah, we are try using a method, I mean a function which is specifically available to the type number. And this time if you notice, the property to fixed does not exist on type string. Yeah, so that's how the type unknown and type any differs. And also one more thing I wanted to mention, so whenever we declare any variable with type any or any runtime values with type any, so in that case, you can propagate a same type to the objects which is created based on that value or based on that value. For example, so I'm creating one variable with type any and initializing with the empty object, then creating one more variable and trying to assign the loosely typed variable. And then if you noticed, I'm just trying to create an nested objects. If you noticed, still the types of the nested objects are type any only, so that's the power of this type any. But obviously your runtime will not break, because it is not aware of, I mean, the particular object which is not declared, so that's why it is throwing a runtime error. But still, if you notice, the compiler won't say anything. So yeah. So that's all for type any. And we have to, I mean, before using type any, we have to make sure that is it really worth of losing the type check in the compilation time. So because if you are manipulating anything with the runtime data, so in that case, if the runtime data contains more nested objects, so if you just opt out the compilation check, then that may cause you the big problem in the runtime. So it's better to avoid using the type any unless it's needed. All right, let's move to type void. So yeah, basically we use type void to declare a variable or a function which is not going to return anything at all. For example, let me create an function which can just having the purpose of warning the user in the runtime. So it's not going to return anything to any further compilation or further manipulation. So the ultimate purpose of this function is just throwing a warning to the user. In that case, we don't need any return type, I mean, no, any return value. So yeah, so a compiler won't throw any error saying that if you try access this function as well, it won't throw any compilation error. Yeah, that's how void can be used, and ultimately we can assign null and undefined to the variable which is created with the type void. Let's demonstrate that as well. And yeah, we can define null, and this can be acceptable only when we do not have strict null checks enabled in our TypeScript configuration file. And if you enabled that strict null check in the TS config, then it will may I mean it will throw you an error saying that type null cannot be, I mean the value null cannot be assigned to the variable which is declared with the type void. So now we are not getting that compilation error because we do not set that strict null checks. Let's try assign undefined. Yeah, so this is also can be acceptable because the null and undefined can be assigned to the variable which is declared with the type void. So yeah, I guess we have covered both type that we have planned, the type any and the type void.